So one of the first things that most people don't know about the admin panel is that you can actually add multiple domains to your Google account. I've seen many a business owner who has actually created multiple G Suite or Google Workspace accounts just because they have multiple brands or multiple divisions in the business. Well, you can actually set up multiple accounts, and you can see here we've got itgenius.com, itgenius.asia, and itgenius.com.au. Now, you can set these up as an alias domain, and an alias domain basically means that it's just like a carbon copy of another domain. Anything, you know, peter at itgenius.com will also work for peter at itgenius.com.au. Any user you create will automatically have two mailboxes. But you can also create something called an add-on domain or a standalone domain. And what they do is they allow you to have multiple buckets of email, multiple domains. So maybe I'm peter at itgenius.com and I have fred at itgenius.com.au for that market, and he wants to actually use that. So Woolworths are a very famous customer of G Suite, Google Workspace. They have, I think, about 300,000 users across not just Woolworths, but all of their brands. And so other brands that they own are BWS. They used to own a company called Masters. And so those businesses, each user can be under the same Google account if you wish, and actually have different primary mailboxes. So if you've got different brands, you can run them all under one account. The good thing is that everyone gets to share and chat together. And if you've got multiple brands and you want one person to work from multiple different email addresses, you don't actually have to pay for an extra license for that person. Each bucket of email is the only thing that you need to pay for a license. So it can be pretty savvy if you've got a big business, multiple brands, and lots of people that are working in the business. Let's go to the next one. All right, manage bookmarks. Let's do manage bookmarks. So manage bookmarks are super useful. Manage bookmarks will allow you to actually force bookmarks down to each one of your users' computers. So you can see here that I have a folder called links, and in that links folder, I've got a number of different websites. And effectively, I'm designating what sites I want to appear there. And so if I want to have a certain set of bookmarks that all my team have access to, our CRM system, our online management system, our task management system, our, even things like our intranet inside of Google Sites, I've got them all available in one place. So again, this is inside Chrome, it's inside settings, and then you go to user and browsers. And then once you're inside user and browsers, if you search for bookmarks, oops, and it would help if I can spell. Here we go. Managed bookmarks, they are called. And from the managed bookmarks menu, you can automatically plop down all of the different bookmarks that you'd like to have. You can give each of them a name. And as soon as you hit save, it's going to basically deploy them down to Chrome for you and your users, which means that everyone gets access to the same set of bookmarks, which is really awesome. Now, finally, the last tip for admins, the setting that you really must enable is called DKIM authentication. Now, as well as actually enforcing two-step verification, which I will show you as a little bonus in a moment, we want you to switch on DKIM. And what DKIM allows you to do is actually authenticate emails that are going outside of your domain. And so if you open up the DKIM menu just by searching inside of Google Admin, that's going to bring up this authentication page. You're going to generate a record, and then from there, you need to have someone update that in your DNS. Now, if you're a little unsure about working with your DNS, I would strongly suggest you have our team help with that. It's not the kind of thing that I would recommend that you do yourself. It's better to have a professional look at it, because if you get something wrong, you can very easily break your email. And our team spend all day long cleaning up other people's DNS messes, because most people don't have a network engineering degree to be able to do it correctly. But what DKIM will do is kind of like seal the emails that you send as authentic and coming from you. It's kind of like the equivalent in the modern day of what you had in the olden days of when someone sent a letter and had a wax seal stamped onto that letter, you would know that it came from a particular person. And so DKIM authentication is absolutely critical, because in the days of spam and phishing and all kinds of challenges with email systems all over the world, this is another step of authentication, which ensures that the emails that you send are treated as legitimate. And it also means that if you get an email from your CFO and it says, hey, transfer $50,000 into this foreign bank account, you can be sure that it actually came from one of your staff members rather than someone completely random. Now, I did mention that I would help you guys out with two-factor authentication. This is an absolute imperative step for admins to do. And so inside, I'm going to try and find it. It's inside the security menu. If you search for the word verification inside of security, you will find two-step verification as a submenu, and that submenu will allow you to actually enforce two-step verification for your users. And what that means is everyone is forced to set up two-step verification. And what I like from here is you can actually force it on for absolutely everyone. You can choose a date on which to enforce it from. So if you've not set it up right now, you can actually say, right, from next week, it's going to be switched on and everyone will get an email and a notification letting them know that that's what's happening. And then you can actually choose when a new user is set up, how long have they got before they're forced to set up their two-step verification. We choose one day. We like that to happen pretty quickly. And you can see there's a number of other options there as well. And so they are the most important admin features for you to set up. If you are an admin of a Google account, then you want to make sure that you get those right. So I have a question here from Roberto, who has asked, out of all the workspace features we have available, what's the most challenging to set up? Could we talk about context-aware app access or LDAP? Is there any knowledge that I will share about that? Roberto, those features are not typically broadly appealing, so we may have them in an upcoming video, but if you're interested in getting help with those, then you can certainly chat to our team. Jump on the details below this video. There's a link to chat to our team if you're interested in getting help with some of the most advanced features inside of Workspace, but I appreciate you asking that question. Next up, we have one from Kailsa saying, is there another storage option from Google Drive as it gets filled up fast? Kailsa, I'm interested to know what Google Workspace plan you're on, because if you're on the standard plan, then you now have 2 terabytes of allocation per user, which for most businesses is absolutely ample. If you're on the most basic plan, I think it's now called Starter, well, that plan only has 30 gigabytes per person, which does get filled up quite quickly. There are additional storage options available. If you're interested in some help with those, jump on the link below and have a chat to our team at IT Genius. Kailsa has said, I'm using Copper CRM. Does Google have their own inbuilt CRM linked to email? Or is there something new coming up with it? Right now, I do not know of any plans for Google to build a CRM system. They are certainly building some basic tasks into chat, which is pretty cool, but I don't know of any relationship-based CRM with Google. What I would also say is that even if Google did have a go at creating a CRM, most CRM systems are quite specialized in what they do. There are some that are focused on marketing. There are some that are focused on integrations and automation. There are some like Copper CRM, which are highly focused on building strong relationships and deep integration with Google Workspace. And so we're a Copper partner. We highly recommend Copper. Great to hear that you're using Copper. That's awesome. But I would say that probably not much coming from Google in this space right now. Hence, the best access we can get to a great CRM is through third-party tools. And if you're interested in that, for anyone watching, jump on the link below, have a chat to our team. Leanne has asked, if someone is short on power, can you stop an application if you have set up their desktop to save power or internet usage to only what is needed? That is a very interesting question. Google have some very basic and rudimentary tools around desktop, or it's called endpoint management. They're available in the enterprise version of Google. If you're interested in those, have a chat to our team. I don't know how much would be able to be controlled in terms of what level of app access or restriction on a desktop level, but there are certainly third-party tools which can definitely help with that. I just want to finish up by saying, no matter where you are in your business journey, if you're a launch business or a startup business and you're early stages in the business, you are more than welcome to have a chat to our team. We offer a free consultation to chat about the technology strategy in your business. We will help you as much as possible. We may present our services, or we may recommend other services that are a better fit to you. We're all about helping small business owners play a bigger game, and we'll help you in whatever way we can. So if you're interested in that, jump on the link down below and have a chat to our team, and we can help you go from launch to startup to growth to scale and to a place of freedom for you, the business owner. Now, if you haven't already joined our amazing, thriving community inside our Google Workspace community on Facebook, please go ahead and join that. We have exclusive videos. You get early access to videos. You get access to our live videos as well, which you may be watching this right now if you're on the live. Thanks so much for joining, guys. Love being here with you. Love all the questions and your interaction. I appreciate you guys here. If you've not yet got in touch with our team, go ahead and do that. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. We'll do our best to get to all of your comments. Can't do that forever. Our subscribers are growing. So right now I'm still in the place where we can respond to every single comment, and we do our best to. But for those of you who need some extra help, be sure to reach out to our team. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much for being a part of it, guys. And we will catch you soon. Cheers.